that your baby boy will one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? This sleeping child you're holding is the great
my King Jesus. Jesus.
Mary. Mary, where are you?
I'm here, Joseph.
Shalom, Mary. I have wonderful news for you today. Shalom, baby Jesus. How are you this afternoon? Oh, Mary, look. Isn't he handsome? And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, thou shalt bring forth the Son, thou shalt call his name Jesus.
And he shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David.
And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Here, Mary.
But Joseph, you haven't told me the good news yet.
Oh, yes. Mary, do you remember the old rabbi who circumcised baby Jesus?
Of course. How could I forget him?
Well, he's just hired me to repair the little synagogue in Bethlehem.
Oh, Joseph, that's wonderful. That will provide us with enough money to remain in Bethlehem until the day of my purification. We can fulfill the law of Moses before returning to Nazareth.
Uh-huh. We can also have money to pay for our lodging, to buy food, and to pay the 5 shekels required by the law of Moses, because baby Jesus is a firstborn.
And we can also buy a lamb for the sacrifice of my purification.
I'm sorry, Mary. I don't think we'll have enough for a lamb. We'll have to offer the 2 young pigeons that the law allows.
Thank the Lord. God is so good to us, Joseph.
Oh, Mary, you're very good to me. I wish I could give you everything you deserve.
I am grateful to God for giving me a man like you, Joseph, to take care of me and Jesus.
You know, Mary, I think it would be better if we stayed to live here in Bethlehem.
You mean, not going back to our home in Nazareth?
Yes. I think we would do well to live here. Some of my uncles and their families live here. And also...
Also what, Joseph?
Oh, Mary, you know that nobody in Nazareth likes us. I can't stand people talking bad about you. They can't help it, though. They don't understand what we're living.
Thank you, Joseph. But you know I don't care what people say about me. Besides, I pray for all of them, because they don't know who this baby is. If only people could understand who he is. One day, they will know.
Yes. But until that day, I believe Jesus and you deserve to live in peace. I know you're very brave, and I know that we may never get rid of criticism. But for now, Nazareth is not a good place for us to live in.
I think you're right, Joseph. Let's stay. After all, isn't Bethlehem the city of King David? It is a good place for his son to live.
All right. But I have more good news, Mary. The priest gave me my first payment in advance. Let's go now to the market to buy food for the week.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Upon thee and give thee peace.
This is a beautiful Monday morning, isn't it, brothers?
Yeah, and very good for business, isn't it, Ananias?
Of course, Cephas. Today is a day of sacrifices. We will sell many, many lambs today.
Yeah, I saw your family installing their stalls in the portal of Solomon again.
Oh, come on, Zachariah. The lamb business in the temple is a great help for all the people who come to worship the Lord.
Oh, that's what you, the Sadducees, think, huh?
Shalom Aleichem, brothers.
Shalom Aleichem, Rabbi.
Ananias, isn't he the Rabbi Simeon?
The famous old teacher himself.
I thought he would be dead by now.
He is certainly a very old man. Almost 90 years old, but he is one of the most respected men in Jerusalem, a true spiritual Israelite who does not have a single blemish on his reputation among our people.
That's what he was in the past, Zechariah. Now, he's just an old nut.
What do you mean, Aeneas?
Do you know, he could have become a high priest in the temple. He despised that privilege just because he believes that politics should not be mixed with religion.
That's what my father taught. But I think the old people don't understand the world they live in. We are no longer in the days of King David. Now, the Roman Empire is the modern world. Even Israel has to adapt to that reality.
Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled? For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewn out cisterns, broken cisterns, that can hold no water.
Yes, yes, Zachariah. Cephas, you know what happened when a man starts to feel that he's more spiritual than the others. And he starts to get involved in supernatural beliefs. The poor old man went out one day saying that he would not die until the coming of the Messiah. Nonsense.
That poor rabbi, he has one foot in the grave and the other one sliding fast. And he thinks he's going to see the coming of the Messiah? Where did he get that nonsense?
The Holy Ghost revealed it to him in a vision.
Nice. Please. David died waiting for the Messiah. And all the prophets died waiting for the Messiah. And who is this old man to believe that he will be alive to see when the Messiah comes? The days of miracles have passed. What a pity for the poor old man.
Ananias, I believe if the Holy Ghost revealed it to him, he has the right to believe it. Caiaphas, had you ever heard the story from the little Simeon himself?
Nope.
Well, here comes Simeon. Let him explain it to you. Brother Simeon, would you be so kind to explain to this young man about your vision in the temple?
Oh, blessed be your heart, my son. Absolutely. Almost 20 years ago, during the Pesach celebration, the Passover day, I had the privilege of standing next to the brazen altar during the sacrifice of the lambs. My duty that year was to receive the bowl with blood from the hands of the priest bearer line and to pour the blood of the sacrifices upon the side of the brazen altar. It was one of the greatest honors I've had in my life. It was around the sixth hour of the day. I had the bowl of blood in my hands, about to pour it upon the altar, when suddenly there was darkness all over the land. The sun refused to shine. Then the earth did quake and the rocks rent. A cloud of dust rose everywhere. I looked around and nobody seemed to see what I saw. Then I saw a man in white robes standing next to the brazen altar. I was scared. And then he spoke. He told me, "Fear not, Simeon. Thy prayer is heard, for thou hast waited for the consolation of Israel. Thus said the Lord God Almighty, behold, thine eyes shall see the salvation of God, for thou shalt see not death before thou hast seen the Messiah, who shall bring eternal redemption unto the uttermost parts of the earth." And then everything vanished. I looked around, and everything was just the same as before. My fellow priest looked at me in amazement, and I understood that it was a vision from God. Ever since then, I'm waiting for my Lord and Savior, the King of Israel. Since then, I tell everyone, Maranatha, Christ is coming. do not have many days left, my son. The coming of the Lord is at hand. I'm sure that you, young Caiaphas, will also see him with your own eyes. I hope God allows you to receive him in your heart. Shalom Aleichem, brothers, and may his coming rejoice your hearts.
Of course, Rabbi. Thank you so much for sharing this with us. But now, we have to return to our duties, so if you would excuse us.
Shalom, precious Rabbi. Shalom.
Shalom, brothers. Shalom.
Oh, please.
Humbug.
Ah, you fanatics.
These people have eyes to see and see not. They have ears to hear and hear not. For they are a rebellious house. You know, Simeon, those two men are brilliant scholars, and they are gaining a lot of influence with the authorities in Jerusalem. Both are seen as potential candidates to one day be high priest.
But God hides and reveals himself in simplicity. Isn't it so, brother? The birth of little John, your son, should have opened the eyes of many in Israel. But it seems that light blinds the eyes of those who love this world more than they love the kingdom of God.
What is that little scroll, Simeon?
Oh, this. I like to copy some of the parts of the scripture to continue studying them at home.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, my brother, I have to continue with my duties. Shalom Aleichem.
Shalom Aleichem, brother. Let's see, Lord, what you want to say to your servant this morning. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam. Oh, this is the book of Isaiah. Oh, hallelujah. Yeled Yulad Ben. Yeled Yulad Ben, Nitan Batehi, Hamizra, Shikmov. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. Vajikrav Semon, and his name shall be called Pele, Wonderful, Yoatz, Counselor, El Gibor, the Mighty God, Aviad, the Everlasting Father, Sar Shalom, the Prince of Peace. Oh my God! This is none other than the Messiah! Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace! For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. A virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Of course, all these years we have looked for a great man or a warrior, but the Messiah will be a baby. Oh, blessed be the Lord.
Simeon. Simeon.
Did you say something, Ananias?
No, Rabbi, I didn't.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought...
Stand up, Simeon.
Great Jehovah, is that you? What do you want me to do?
Start walking.
Where am I going, Lord?
Don't make any difference. Just keep walking. I lead you.
Simon, sons and daughters of God are led by the Spirit of God. Here I go, Lord. My Lord, I'm walking.
Good thing we came first.
That's the good thing about getting up early.
I hope the priests don't make us wait too long.
Oh, sister, shh, don't talk like that. We are in the house of the Lord.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Don't forget, reverence in the house of the Lord.
Reverence, yes. Naomi, where is your husband?
It's Monday morning. Where do you think he is? He can't leave the stall. This is the day that we make the most money.
Oh, yes, it's true. You're right. My husband is buying the lamb for the sacrifice. He will come shortly. If he doesn't stay talking to his friends, the merchants.
That's for sure.
Right?
Your baby is so beautiful. What's his name?
Aw, thank you. His name is Jehoiakim ben Elakim, like his grandfather. What's the name of your baby?
Judas, son of Simon Iscariot. We chose an elegant and distinguished name because my husband says that our son will do great things when he grows up.
He is very handsome, and that onesie is so beautiful.
I only buy in Roman stores. There you can find everything for babies.
My husband bought this little outfit when he was traveling to Babylon.
Oh, darling, it's beautiful. Jehoiakim looks like a little gentleman.
I know, right? And in this little bag, he brings his 5 silver shekels to give the priest for his birthright.
Oh, darling, it's so cute.
Thank you.
Oh, look! That must be the lamb for my sacrifice. My husband paid for it in advance last Saturday to the temple merchants. You know, they just charged him a little bit more for delivering it to the outer courts.
Naomi, look! Look who's coming over here!
Oh, that's Elizabeth. She's the wife of Zechariah the priest.
Shalom, Naomi. Shalom, Tamar. How fast the day of your purification has arrived. Welcome to the temple of the Lord, little gentleman.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
Oh, what beautiful babies. Congratulations to you both.
Oh, thanks, Elizabeth.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. What are you doing in the temple on this day, Elizabeth?
Zechariah and I are so grateful to God for our son, John, that I promised the Lord to give the temple all the linen cloth that I could spin in a year. So I come now to pay my vow to the Lord.
You are so godly, as always, Elizabeth. I would like to do the same, but Judas doesn't give me time to do anything.
Aw, little John is getting so big.
Ah, yes. His father must be proud.
More than you can imagine, dear. This baby is a great gift from God for an old couple like us.
Elizabeth, was it true that your husband was deaf and dumb during your pregnancy? How is it that he can speak so well today?
Oh, God is doing great things these days, my dear sister. I would love to share the testimony after the service. Oh, my cousin Mary and her husband. Excuse me, my dear sisters. Excuse me.
Oh, Mary, we still have to buy the sacrifice.
Okay, Joseph. Tamar! Well, look at that! Look who is coming into this holy place.
Look! Mary, your cousin Elizabeth.
Oh, Elizabeth! Shalom!
Shalom, Elizabeth.
It's so good to see you again.
Shalom! God bless you. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Oh, John, you're getting so big.
Oh, John is so cute.
Oh, say thank you, John. And I'm getting heavy, too.
Elizabeth, do you know where I can buy animals for sacrifice? I really don't want to buy them from the temple merchants.
Yes, you have to go down the stairs of the Ark, outside the west wall. Do you know where is it at?
Oh yes, thank you.
You're so very welcome.
Mary, I'll be back in a little while.
All right, Joseph. Joseph is very upset. He doesn't like to see people selling in the temple of the Lord. Every time he comes to the temple, he says,
May God one day get all of these thieves out of his house.
He's right, Mary. Zachariah thinks the same thing. How are you, little Jesus?
Zachariah thinks the same thing.
If you were as holy as you say you are, you would get away from your little cousin.
Why do you say that, Naomi?
Oh, honestly, that woman is not worthy to be in this temple, Tamar. She was already pregnant before she married that man.
Really?
Yes. The only reason she is alive today is because he did not accuse her.
So you mean that that baby is not even from that man? And he forgave her? Disgusting. They should have stoned her.
Well, of course they should have, Tamar. But if the man doesn't accuse her, the law can't do anything. That's why they come among the holy people like they haven't done anything.
Yeah, and look at those rags that they are dressed in. I bet you they have no money to buy a lamb for their sacrifice.
By the way they look, I doubt they even have money to eat.
Right?
Baruch haba v'shem Adonai.
Baruch haba v'shem Adonai.
Shalom aleichem.
Amen.
We are about to start the service this morning. To all those who have brought your firstborn sons, prepare the 5 silver shekels, according to the law that God gave to the prophet Moses, for the redemption of the sons who opens the womb. Prepare the corresponding sacrifice for each woman for the purification ceremony, to the glory of the Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Daddy's coming over there. Say hi, John.
Hi, John. Elizabeth, you must be tired. I wish I could help you with the baby, but I'm in service right now.
I know, Zachariah. Don't worry. Look who came to the temple today.
Mary and the little Jesus.
Shalom, Zachariah.
Shalom aleichem.
I'm back, Mary. Did I take too long?
No, Joseph. You just came in time.
Is everything all right, Mary? What's wrong, Elizabeth?
She is just bearing the reproach for the sake of the word, Joseph.
Oh, Mary.
Don't worry, Joseph. They don't know who this baby is. That's it.
Look, Naomi, 2 pigeons. I told you that they didn't have enough money for a lamb.
I'm not surprised, darling. God does not bless sinners.
The best thing for us will be to keep our distance from those people. I can't believe that my Jehoiakim has to grow up with a child like that.
I hope my Judas won't have anything to do with an illegitimate child like him.
Keep walking, Simeon.
Where am I going, Father?
Just go to that line of women. Down along there. Go to that couple.
What do I have to know about them, my Lord?
Wonderful. Counselor. The mighty God. The everlasting Father. The Prince of Peace.
The Messiah! Oh, God! Oh, my God!
Naomi! Naomi, look! Who is that old man?
I think it's the Rabbi Simeon.
But why is he going to them?
Shh! Let me listen!
My children, blessed of the Lord. I am old Simon. Something is happening right now. I understand that you're believers of God, but I can assure you, the Holy Spirit has sent me to approach you. Sweet girl, please, would you allow this old man to hold your baby?
Of course, Abba Simeon.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. May both be blessed. Oh, Lord. Now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace.
according to thy word. For mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, a light to lighten the Gentiles and the glory of thy people Israel.
What?
Why would these people say these things? Don't they know who they are?
The great God, creator of heaven and earth, rich in mercy, be with you.
Amen.
Amen.
For he had confidence in placing in your arms the greatest treasure that this world will ever receive.
Amen.
Here is your baby, my sweet girl. Behold, this child is set for the fall and rising again of many in Israel.
Praise the Lord.
And for a sign which shall be spoken against.
Amen.
Yea, a sword shall pierce through your own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed.
Come.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God. Fanatics.
Where is he? Where is he, my Lord? Where is your Messiah?
Ananias. That's a blind Anna. She spends day and night in the temple praying, and has done so since I can remember.
How many more fanatics we need here?
Make way for old Anna. Make way for the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. Where is your Messiah, my Lord?
What? Oh, wow. Naomi, that woman is crazy.
I don't understand these people.
Listen to me, all of you who are waiting for the redemption of Israel. I am blind and I can't see. But in the midst of my darkness, the light of God enlightened
Praise
me and told me.
Glory to God.
Anna, get up and go to the women's court, because there you will find the Prince Messiah.
Sister Anna!
Old Simeon, that's your voice. I know it is.
Yes.
I knew you would be here too. Come, my brother, help me.
Come to me. Follow my voice.
Where is he, Simon? Take me to him.
Come. Come this way. Come. Here he is, Anna.
Oh, my daughter. You're just a girl. Blessed is she who believed in the word of the Lord.
I was married 7 years, and after my husband died, I never had a child, but I'm sure I know how to hold this baby.
Yes, of course. Take him.
I still can't see you, my king, but very soon I will see you.
Amen.
Thank you, my Lord, for giving your unworthy servant this privilege and this testimony.
Praise the Lord.
What do you think about this? If the Holy Spirit could guide an old woman in the midst of her darkness and lead her to the Savior of the world, I am sure that he can guide you to him too. The Holy Spirit can guide you to Christ.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise
Hallelujah.
God.
Please tell me, what is the name of your baby?
His name is Jesus.
Jesus, our Savior.
A sign shall be given, a virgin will conceive, a human baby bearing undiminished deity. The glory of the nations, a light for all to see, hope for all who will embrace his warm reality. So what will be your answer? Will you hear the call of him who did not spare his son, but gave him for us all. On earth there is no power, there is no depth or height that could ever separate us from the love of God in Christ.
Who could stand again?